Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, The Adventure of the Sussex Vampire, an audiobook recorded by David McCran. Holmes had read carefully a note which the last post had brought him. Then, with the dry chuckle which was his nearest approach to a laugh, he tossed it over to me. For a mixture of the modern and the medieval, of the practical and the wildly fanciful, I think this is surely the limit, said he. What do you make of it, Watson? I read as follows. 46, Old Jury, November 19th, regarding vampires. Sir, our client, Mr. Robert Ferguson, of Ferguson and Muirhead, tea brokers of Mincing Lane, has made some inquiry from us in a communication of even date concerning vampires. As our firm specializes entirely upon the assessment of machinery, the matter hardly comes within our purview, and we have therefore recommended Mr. Ferguson to call upon you and lay the matter before you. We have not forgotten your successful action in the case of Matilda Briggs. We are, sir, faithfully yours, Morrison, Morrison and Dodd, per EJC. Matilda Briggs was not the name of a young woman, Watson, said Holmes in a reminiscent voice. It was a ship which is associated with the giant rat of Sumatra, a story for which the world is not yet prepared. But what do we know about vampires? Does it come within our purview either? Anything is better than stagnation, but we really seem to have been switched on to a Grimm's fairy tale. Make a long arm, Watson, and see what V has to say. I leaned back and took down the great index volume to which he referred. Holmes balanced it on his knee, and his eyes moved slowly and lovingly over the record of old cases, mixed with the accumulated information of a lifetime. Voyage of the Glorious Scott, he read. That was a bad business. I have some recollection that you made a record of it, Watson, though I was unable to congratulate you upon the result. Victor Lynch, the forger. Venomous lizard or gila? Remarkable case that. Vittoria, the circus bell. Vanderbilt and the Yeggman. Vipers, Vigor, the Hammersmith wonder. Hello, hello. Good old index. Oh, you can't beat it. Listen to this, Watson. Vampirism in Hungary. And again, vampires in Transylvania. He turned over the pages with eagerness. But after a short, intent perusal, he threw down the great book with a snarl of disappointment. Rubbish, Watson, rubbish. What have we to do with walking corpses who can only be held in their grave by stakes driven through their hearts? It's pure lunacy. But surely, said I, the vampire was not necessarily a dead man. A living person might have the habit. I have read, for example, of the old sucking the blood of the young in order to retain their youth. You are right, Watson. It mentions the legend in one of these references. But are we to give serious attention to such things? This agency stands flat-footed upon the ground, and there it must remain. The world is big enough for us. No ghosts need apply. I fear that we cannot take Mr. Robert Ferguson very seriously. Possibly this note may be from him, and may throw some light upon what is worrying him. He took up a second letter, which had lain unnoticed upon the table while he had been absorbed with the first. This he began to read with a smile of amusement upon his face, which gradually faded away into an expression of intense interest and concentration. When he had finished, he sat for some little time lost in thought, with the letter dangling from his fingers. Finally, with a start, he aroused himself from his reverie. Cheeseman's Lamberley. Where is Lamberley, Watson? Is it not Sussex, south of Horsham? Not very far, eh? And Cheeseman's? I know that country, Holmes. It is full of old houses which are named after men who built them centuries ago. You get Audleys and Harveys and Carrotons. The folk have forgotten, but their names live in their houses. Precisely, said Holmes coldly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.